This is an inside micrometer set. What we have is the measuring head. We have different rods that will go in the end of the measuring head. So this would be a 2 to 3 inch rod, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, and 7 to 8. It is not uncommon to have a set that is up to 12 inches. It will start at 2 inches and go up from there. The main scale here will read up to a half inch. So it'll read from 2 inches to 2.5 inches. If I need to go from 2.5 to 3 inches, this spacer would then go in. So if we have a look at it, we have the same scale on it as is found on your micrometer. Again, the difference is it goes from 0 to 1/2 inch. The rod actually goes in the end of it, and it is locked in place with this lock nut here. Now the rod will stay in place. Again, it'll read the 1/2 inch. If I need to go in between the two, we would put the spacer sleeve on and insert it into the end and tighten it up, and then that would allow me to read from 2.5 to 3 inches across these two measuring faces here. The second knurled screw that's on the bottom here will allow me, if I take this out, I could put an extension rod in here so I can get deep inside a bore to read with this inside micrometer. With the proper rod in your inside micrometer selected and the proper spacer in place, we can now measure the inside diameter of a part. What I want to do is I want to hold one of these measuring faces against the inside of the bore, and I want to take the tool and rock it in and out and back and forth, holding it on a pivot point on the far end as I'm turning this sleeve here. What I want to do is feel a slight drag going in and out and back and forth, and then I'll pull it out. I want to use great care pulling it out of the bore because there's no lock nut on this thimble. It's a really good practice to check the size over a micrometer that you've already calibrated. Again, doing the same thing, back and forth and in and out as I'm turning the thimble, and just getting it to slightly drag across the face. Check the reading. This is a direct reading instrument. The problem is there are adjustable measuring faces on the end of the rod and also on the end of the measuring head, and it is possible that it could be slightly out of calibration. So you always want to check it against the micrometer. If we have a look now, we can see that we have the 2-inch rod in plus the 1/2-inch spacer, and if we look at the sleeve, we can see the 100 thou mark plus 2 graduations exposed, so 0.125, 0.150 on the sleeve. If we come up to the thimble, we can see the 8 lines up with the datum line. Each one of these graduations is 0.001, so this would be 0.008 or 8 thou. So 2 inches, 5, 2.5, 2.6, 2.625, 50, 2.6, 58. 2 inch, 658 thou is the final size.